Students, we shall now prove the property 8 number 2, that is integration of 0 to infinity f s of f of x into g s of g of x into ds is equal to integration of 0 to infinity f of x into g of x dx. Now let us start the problem from the left hand side. The left hand side is f s of f of x into g s of g of x into ds is equal to integration of 0 to infinity is taken as it is, f s of f of x is also taken as it is. Now let us substitute for g s of g of x. G s of g of x is nothing but the Fourier sine transform of g of x. The Fourier sine transform of g of x will be given by square root of 2 divided by pi integration of 0 to infinity g of x into sine s x dx into ds. Now by changing the order of integration, we can get the right hand side of 1 can be now written as integration of 0 to infinity g of s is brought in front, integration of 0 to infinity g of x into square root of 2 divided by pi integration of 0 to infinity f s of f of x into sine s x into ds. Ds into dx. Now you look into the expression A. Looking into the expression A, we can observe that the expression A is the inversion formula for sine transforms. The first step is to change the order of integration, and now we are looking into the expression A. The expression A is the inversion formula for sine transforms. Now the inversion formula for sine transform is given by f of x is equal to square root of 2 divided by pi integration of 0 to infinity f s of f of x into sine s x ds. Now compare the expression A with this formula f of x is equal to square root of 2 divided by pi integration of 0 to infinity f s of f of x into sine. So expression A can be replaced by f of x. Now integration of 0 to infinity g of x into square root of 2 divided by pi integration of 0 to infinity f s of f of x sine s x ds into dx is taken as expression B. Now expression B can be written as integration of 0 to infinity g of x is written as it is, and the expression A can be replaced by f of x into dx. Now the required proof is integration of 0 to infinity fs of f of x into gs of g of x into ds is equal to integration of 0 to infinity f of x into g of x into dx. This is what the required proof is.